This review is sponsored by Picky. You love it, you hate it, you're not sure what to think. That's normal, we're human, we all like different music, but what you maybe don't know is that there's an app that lets you be the judge, an app that feeds you short song clips to rate based on your own personal taste. Picky is the name of the app, it's fun and super easy to use, you literally just click the link in the description, download, hit the center button to load up the music, and you're in. The algorithm quickly learns what you seem to be liking or skipping to give you even more music that you'll like, and now recommendations are even better since you can easily connect your Spotify account and let the bots learn your faves even faster. Basically, it's like a dating app, but for music, since you can like, dislike, or super like a song, and if you hit that super like, they'll stick together in a playlist, which is dope if you find something you're into and want to hear it again later. What makes Picky even cooler is that you can literally get paid through Venmo every time you level up, and all you have to do is rate the song clips and discover music, and it's another dollar in your pocket. Download the app for free, it's linked below, and thanks again to Picky for supporting my channel. If you're wondering what my intro song is, you're not alone, because Lil Nas X himself DM'd me in 2019 asking the exact same thing. It's in the description, first of all, Lil Nas X, but second of all, of course, I'm going to leave the DMs open for the man, the myth, the legend himself. That's the only way I could think of to not so subtly flex that to open this review. Welcome back to ARTV. My name is John. Let's review Montero, the debut album by the singer, rapper, troller extraordinaire, Lil Nas X. Everyone thought this guy was gonna be a one-hit wonder after Old Town Road and its various remixes topped the Billboard Hot 100 for the longest amount of time ever. It was a record setter, but Lil Nas X was never gonna be content with just having one song that blew up. The man's an absolute genius in the way that he markets himself and his music. He's provocative to the point where he gets people outraged over absolutely nothing. There's headlines and there's people talking. I could say just a few words and you know what I'm talking about. I could say Nike, I could say blood shoes, I could say stripper pole and Satan, and you know what the hell I'm talking about. But dazzling visuals and trending on social media can only take you so far if you don't have the music to back it up, and Lil Nas X proves with his debut full-length album Montero that he has the chops, and that's coming from someone who didn't think his debut EP 7 necessarily got fully cooked. This project feels fully realized, like he's taking a direction, he's taking a stance, but he's also not pigeonholing himself. Montero the album manages to cover a lot of ground without sounding distractingly unbalanced. This is an album that flows well from start to finish. It's not extremely bloated, even though it does have 15 tracks. It comes in at a perfect 42 minutes, a listen that you can easily sit through and not feel exhausted by the time it's over. Lil Nas X continues to be a boundary breaker, not just because he's trying on so many different genres and pulling it off so well. This is also an openly gay black man that is rapping, singing, dancing, and doing a lot of things that the rap community, who has a tendency to be a little bit homophobic, they're not normally so accepting of. The three singles from this record expertly mapped out exactly what Lil Nas X wanted to do with this album, the different directions and explorations it would take on. You have the more somber, skeletons in the closet type of song, Sun Goes Down, which is a lot more introspective, and that's fitting because there's other moments where he definitely gets raw and honest, and I love that vulnerability, but you've also got the banger like Industry Baby featuring Jack Harlow that absolutely won my heart. I'm not a Jack Harlow fan at all, but I loved his verse. Lil Nas X kills it, the beat is fire, and then you have Montero, Call Me By Your Name, which is just so ridiculously catchy and well-produced. I think it's great that he didn't put too much emphasis on only having the bangers on the album, the ones that would stand out as like a playlist or a radio feature, just jumping off the page screaming to be played. This does have a lot of softer songs to it, but that doesn't mean that they don't stick with you or get stuck in your head in some way. Those raw moments serve as the perfect contrast to the more braggadocious content, the ones that are a bit more flamboyant and in your face, so everything kind of falls into place the way it was meant to. You'll see when you dive into Montero that it feels more like he's found his own voice, the lane that he wants to continue opening up. And while his influences can be a little bit too much at times, I hear everything from Travis Scott to other genres and styles of music that might remind you of several other artists, it never gets too overwhelming because of the fact that he's very steadfast in his deliveries, and he's emotive, he's also playful. There's a lot of skill that goes into bringing personality and color to music, but Lil Nas X is able to do that all throughout the track list. It never gets stale, it never gets boring. The features, for the most part, are on point, if not a little bit too short in places, in the example of Doja Cat. But overall, this is a project that continuously sculpts exactly what Nas is wanting to say, and I think that most of the nails hit square on the head. Now, I brought up that Doja Cat feature that's on the track Scoop, which is incredibly catchy. I love that cycling rhythmic beat. There's just so much fire and gusto powering it. Nas is talking about the fact that he's getting in shape. He's very open with his sexuality, something that he had been criticized for in the past. Even though he had come out of the closet, people were wanting to embrace it even more. I personally don't feel it's anybody else's place to say when or what they should do or what they should talk about, but this one has come full term, and I love that. And I do wish that there was a little bit more to the Doja Cat feature. I like where it was going, but overall, I can't complain. This is one of the biggest bangers on here. Dead Right Now might be the best damn song on Montero alongside Industry Baby, and I'm so glad that this didn't come out as a single. It didn't spoil it, because this is something that you just want to take a bite of in the actual track list as you're listening through the album for the first time. He paints this really harrowing portrait of an unaccepting family, people who used him, spit him out, and now suddenly want something. And these are themes that have been handled a million times over because of people blowing up, talking about their fame, but this is something that feels very different because it's very catchy, very melodic at surface level, but there's a lot of darkness and a lot of loneliness lying in there. You also can't skip The Amazing Void, which puts a lot of emphasis on Lil Nas X and his singing voice, which is actually quite nice. The production really complements it and stands tall as this beautiful guitar meditation. It focuses a lot on drawing inspiration from the early 2000s, and more specifically, it actually reminds me a lot of Bottom of the Ocean by Miley Cyrus, a very open, airy tune. And Miley herself, another member of the Cyrus family collabing with Lil Nas X, plays out on the final song on Montero, a fantastic moment with so much kinetic energy. I'm talking about Am I Dreaming? Their chemistry is off the charts. Their voices line up so well. They bounce off of each other and just radiate. And I could say similar things about the surprising banger $Slime with Megan Thee Stallion, who really pulls out a nice guest verse. It's quick, it's punchy, and it goes straight for the throat. To round it out with two more tracks that I think are really worth discussing, first we have That's What I Want, which is a really brisk, guitar-driven adventure. It's simple, but again, it's his personality that sells it. And then we have Lost in the Citadel, which is, dare I say, borderline pop punk? And I don't want to say it's full on, but it definitely draws from that well. It's not a bad thing. I just wish the drums hammered a little bit harder. They can feel paper thin, but I do love the direction. I love the instrumentation. I like the fact that he's bringing them out on various songs to play off of the more beat-driven tracks. There are times where it feels like the influences are a bit too much or overwhelming, but he never loses his grip. He's always in full control, reeling it back in, keeping it grounded in some way, but also larger than life. I'm giving his debut album Montero a strong 4 out of 5. What did you guys think of Montero by Lil Nas X? Was it worth the wait? Do you agree with my opinion? Did you enjoy his personality overall and the songs? Or did you feel a different way entirely? Let me know in the comment section down below, hit that like button and subscribe, turn on those notifications too so you don't miss out when I post future videos. Thanks again to Picky for sponsoring this video, check them out, top link down below, a couple of recent videos floating on screen now, and all of my socials can be found in the description down below.